Assalamu alaikum viewers, please like, share and subscribe this channel. Links of PDF files used in this video are given in description. So today's lecture is about applications of thermogravimetric analysis or TGA, and this is the lecture 4 of the main topic of thermal methods of analysis. So in the previous lecture we have discussed about the instrumentation of thermogravimetric analysis, and we have studied two different types of thermobalances that are Chavinard balance and Aminko balance. So in today's lecture we will mainly focus on the applications of TGA or thermogravimetric analysis. So there are four major applications of thermogravimetric analysis. Number one is the drying or ignition of precipitates. So we get information about drying temperatures or ignition temperatures of precipitates, or in short we can say what are the safe ranges at which we can dry the precipitates. Second major application is qualitative and quantitative information about our sample. So as we know, TGA is an analytical technique, and we use these analytical techniques to have quantitative and qualitative information. Number third main application is the hygroscopic and kinetic studies. So we also take help of TGA in order to have information about hygroscopic properties and in order to study the reaction kinetics. After then in number four we study the thermal decomposition temperatures. So it is very important to have information that at which particular temperature a particular compound decomposes. So we get this information also from thermogravimetric analysis. And after then the other major application is oxidation of explosives, metals and drugs, that with the help of TGA we get information about at which temperatures the explosives gets oxidized, or the metals gets oxidized, or drugs gets oxidized. Because in explosive flashpoints information is important that at which temperature these will go flash out. The oxidation of metals is important, at which temperatures they will rust or something like that. And oxidation of drugs, or it is also called as decomposition of drugs, at which conditions we should store these drugs. So all this information is obtained from TGA. After then the miscellaneous application includes sublimation behavior of analytical mixture, after then mixture separation, and then determination of physical constants like activation energy, vapor pressure, etc., and study of chemical reactions that are occurring at very high temperature. So all these miscellaneous items and all these major constituents are the applications of TGA. So in the next part of this lecture we will study them separately one by one. So the thermogravimetric analysis is not only important in the field of chemistry, but it is equally important in the field of metallurgy, engineering, ceramics and mineralogy. So if we discuss about different applications, so first we will discuss about the drying and ignition of precipitates, or at which temperatures we should dry or ignite the precipitates. Actually thermogravimetric analysis methodology has been derived from the principles of gravimetry. So in the gravimetry what we do, that we prepare the precipitates of our analyte, and then we dry them, then we weight them, and from that information of weight we determine the nature of the precipitates, so also their qualitative and quantitative analysis. So actually gravimetry was the classical method of analysis. But the problem was that different persons were drying the precipitates at different temperature ranges. So in order to have correct temperature range at which we should dry or ignite the precipitates, so in order to get information of that, we have developed the thermogravimetric technique from that methodology. So for example, Ferric hydroxide indicates the uncertainty in the composition of compound due to gradual removal of water molecules. Hence, in the gravimetric determination of iron, the hydroxide is ignited above 1000 to iron oxide. So, if you are heating the ferric oxide in order to have its qualitative or quantitative information, so below 1000 centigrade, there is reduction in weight, and that reduction in weight is not due to the decomposition of ferric hydroxides or due to the evolution of different compounds, but due to the gradual removal of water from it. So, in order to have a correct information, these precipitates should be ignited at 1000 centigrade or above. So then we will get exact information. Similarly, if we attain a thermogram of nickel DMG complex, then in the thermogram horizontal lines appear at 120 to 1 centigrade, 70 centigrade. So it means that if we want to dry nickel dimethyl glyoxime complex, then it should be at a range of 120 to 1 centigrade, 170 centigrade. So if we see here, this is the graph, and in this way there are two types of portions in this graph. These are the vertical portions. In these vertical portions, the compounds are destroying or decomposing, so these temperatures are not good for analysis or drying. But however, the horizontal portions, at this temperature range, no compound is get heated or destroyed, so its composition remains uniform. So these horizontal portions are good for drying at different temperature ranges. So in this way we get the information about drying and ignition of precipitates, and we also do it without the decomposition of the original compound. So this was the first major application of thermogravimetric analysis. Second major application of TGA is qualitative and quantitative information about analytical sample. So as TGA is a full-fledged technique, so it is obvious that it will be used both for qualitative and quantitative analysis. For example, in TGA we obtain a thermogram. Now every analyte type has a distinct thermogram. So if the two things are of identical nature, then their thermograms will be identical. However, if their thermograms are not matching with each other, it means that two things are different. So in this way, from the information we get from the thermogram, we get information about the qualitative analysis, or we can have estimation that a compound is pure or not, or if it is according to the stoichiometric ratio or not. Similarly, we get the quantitative information. For example, this is the reaction in which magnesium oxalate compound is heated and it removes the water. So information about the weight lost experienced by a given weight of sample is usually sufficient to calculate the percentage of magnesium oxalate in a given sample. So both qualitative and quantitative information is obtained from a particular thermogram, and this is the second major application of TGA or thermogravimetric analysis. Next application of TGA is thermal decomposition and thermal stability. For many years before the discovery of thermogravimetric analysis, many inorganic and organic substances were remained a subject of curiosity for chemists as far as their thermal decomposition is concerned. So in order to have information about different products, the compounds were decomposed until there was no further degradation. So as a result of that, we were not able to get information about different types of intermediates or different types of transition states. As the compounds were burned, and we only determined the stoichiometric information from their residue. But after the discovery of TGA, it was possible to not only determine the stepwise degradation of a compound, but it was also important to have information about intermediates, and this target was successfully achieved by using the thermogravimetric analysis. Similarly, These TGA thermograms helped us in order to have thermostability of various industrial products such as paints, varnishes, packing material, polymers, building materials, alloys and ceramic articles. From two point of views, it was important to have information about these products. Number one, at which temperature range these species can be safely employed in the building of materials, and second, what is their service lifetime. For example, if we want to apply a substance externally in the environment, at which temperatures these compounds retain their stability, or these are decomposed. So all this information is obtained from a particular thermogravimetric analysis or a thermogram developed by TGA instrumentation. Next, the application is hygroscopic studies and kinetics of reactions. So at various ambient temperatures, the analyte mixture absorbs water from air. So by using TGA, we can have information that how much a compound has absorbed water at a particular temperature. Similarly, not only water, we can also determine the information about how much carbon dioxide from the air has been absorbed by a particular compound. Similarly, we can have information from TGA about water of hydration, water of crystallization, and water of coordination. These three types of waters are different in nature. Water of hydration is actually attached ionically with the analyte, whereas water of crystallization is actually during the formation of a crystal, it is the water molecules that are trapped, whereas water of coordination means that water is acting as a ligand and it has been attached to our analyte with the help of coordinate covalent bond. So the strength with which these three types of waters are attached with our analyte is different. So by using TGA, we can have the information that if a particular water is removed, then either it was water of hydration, it was water of crystallization, or it was water of coordination when we obtain the TGA in order to have this information. Similarly, the purity of the compounds was a challenging task due to the continuous removal of water. So if we have a very precise information about the water of hydration, water of crystallization, and water of coordination, one can determine the purity of the particular reagent in very decent manner. Second application was kinetic studies. So the kinetic information was obtained by plotting a series of isotherm curves of weight loss against a time at different temperatures. So this information of kinetics is very important in ceramics and polymer industries. So all this information was also obtained from TGA analysis or by analyzing the thermogram obtained through the analysis of compound by TGA. Next application is oxidation of metals, explosives and drugs. The information at which the compounds get oxidized at which temperature is very important, and this is contrary to the other procedures or the processes that are occurring in the analysis. So as due to the oxidation of metals, in general the weights are decreased, but in case of oxidation of metals, the weight will be increased due to the layer of oxide formation on the top surface of metals. So it is very important to have information at which temperatures the metals get oxidized and its weights is increased. So this information is obtained from the TGA. Similarly, at which temperature the explosives gets oxidized and drugs gets oxidized, it is also very important, because if at a particular temperature a compound or an explosive material gets oxidized, then it means it can get denatured. Similarly, the drugs can be oxidized, and if these get oxidized, so we see that the working mechanism of these drugs become malfunctioned. So in this way, the information about oxidation temperatures of different things is not only important for due to their hazardous nature, but also this gets important if we want to maintain the shelf life of explosives and drugs or metals. So this all information is obtained from the thermogravimetric analysis, and the knowledge of thermal stability range of various drugs helps in predicting their shelf life and storage conditions. So we know the information that at which temperatures we should maintain the storage of explosives and drugs or other materials. So all this information is also obtained from the thermogravimetric analysis or TGA. Apart from above mentioned major applications, there are some miscellaneous applications of thermogravimetric analysis also. These include study of sublimation behavior of various substances, similarly to separate the volatile mixture of components, and synthesis of new intermediates and compounds. Next is to find out the physical constants such as vapor pressure, activation energy and binding energy, similarly to study the reactions at very high temperatures, and to confirm the stoichiometry of compound by analyzing the evolved gases by a gas chromatography during the thermal analysis. So if we say that at which temperature a particular compound get decomposed, so this information is obtained from thermogravimetric analysis, and then those substances or the evolved gases are analyzed by gas chromatography. So in this way, if we have initially the thermogram of a particular compound, then the overall procedure of the experiment becomes very easy, as we know already that at which temperatures the particular compound will evolve. So we get the information of that particular compound by analysis its constituents through gas chromatography. Next is to evaluate the different types of filter papers used in the gravimetric analysis. In order to increase the efficiency of a particular gravimetric analysis, we use different types of filters. So this information can be obtained from thermogravimetric analysis. Similarly, a thermogravimetric balance may be used for measuring magnetic susceptibility of a compound at high temperatures. So magnetic susceptibility means how much magnetic interactions are possible in a particular compound, or how much magnetic interactions with the external magnetic field are possible in a compound, and either that particular compound retain its magnetic properties at a particular temperature or not. This all information we get from the thermogravimetric analysis or the thermogram obtained through TGA. So these were all applications, including major and miscellaneous applications of thermogravimetric analysis or TGA. So I hope you have well understood the lecture, but if you have any question or any confusion, please make a comment in the comment section. I shall reply to it to the best of my knowledge and as soon as possible. Okay, thank you. Allah Hafiz.